the political history of the Israelites, their first form of government could be called theocracy. The government where God was a king. And in this form of kingship, God takes care of his people through the seer, through the prophets, as it were. As time goes on, the people were really used to the leadership of God. And this is what David remembered when he was being pursued by Saul. And David said in Psalm 23, "The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want." David could use this psalm because David himself was a shepherd. And remember that when Samuel was looking for a king, at the request of the people of Israel, who said, "Give us a king like other nations." And Samuel came to the house of David's father. Kish brought out all the children, and there was one of the children, because the first was so tall and huge, and Samuel wanted to anoint him, and God said, "No, I have not chosen this." God does not see as man sees. God looks at the heart, whereas man and woman will look at the appearance. And he went ahead and asked, "Are all these your children?" He said, "No." He said, "There is one who is tending the sheep." He said, "Go and bring him. You must anoint him immediately." So that is how David was anointed. When Goliath threatened Israel, and there was nobody to match with Goliath, David came up as a little boy with, and he said he was going to face Goliath. And so I told David, "You are too small. This man is an expert in war. He's a warrior. And he's made of all women." And this is what David said. He said, "God, who has saved me from the mouth of the lions, will deliver me from this Philistine." That means that in the process of shepherding the sheep of his father, he had encountered lions. And so David could say, "The same God who delivered me from the mouth of the lion will still deliver me from the Philistine." We don't reject to David. But before we arrive at David, some things were now happening. Because the life, the prophetic life of Israel emerged as a kind of continuation to direct the kings. So, the prophets were appointed to speak truth to power. And this is where we can talk about the prophet of social justice, like the prophet Amos. But why do we need a prophet of social justice? Because somehow the kings were become going out, they were deviating from the presence of God, whom David has referred to as the good shepherd. They emerged in Israel categories of prophets. We have false prophets. They are not called by God. They appointed themselves. And they said, "Thus says the Lord." Whereas they were the one who were saying, they somehow they say. Okay. That's a false prophet. Then there were professional prophets. This prophet emerged to say what the king wanted to hear. And they were paid for prophesying lies. Like some leaders today don't remember the constitution except when they want to use it against you. Then we have the true prophets. The true prophets, these were the prophets that were really called by God to speak truth to power. Now, these prophets were supposed to do the work of the good shepherd. And so Psalm 80 verse 1 says, "Oh, give ear, shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph's flock, you are a throne above the cherubim, shine forth." That is what the Psalms say. So if you are a pastor, a priest, and of course pastor means shepherd, and a priest is a pastor. But because of the way the Pentecostals have abused the word pastors, many of us were meant to become priests. Because a priest shares in the triplex monera. What is triplex monera? The three full functions of Christ as a priest, as a prophet, and as a king. So, a priest above all is a prophet, is a shepherd who takes care of the people. And this was what the shepherd was doing. But something happens even as the life continues in Israel. The prophets who were supposed to pray for the people, they were supposed to be praying for the people. What did they do? They started praying on the people. You know the difference? The first prayer is B-R-A-Y. The second prayer is B-R-E-Y. And that is why the prophet Isaiah will say, "You eat up my people as if you were eating bread." And today, many pastors still, you know, pray for the people, they pray on the people. Like one of the pastors would say, "Go and tell your pastors, if you do not pay tithe, you can't go to heaven, full stop." And this is a pastor who objects. Who will that matter for Matthias? So in Genesis chapter 49, verse 23 to 24. But he said, "But is the shepherd, the stone of Israel. The actual bitterly attacked him and shot at him and harassed him. And Psalm 95 verse 7 says, "For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand today." So if you hear his words, don't hide him. She knows that this man is an enemy, registered enemy. It's easy to avoid him. But when a friend plays the role of an enemy, it's so dangerous. That is why Psalm 41 verse 9 says, "If it was an enemy that has done this to me, I will be able to bear it." It's you, my friend. How deep was that friendship? Such that we eat from the same plate and you have turned against me. Psalm 41 verse 9. And that is where today get 419. When Campania told Caesar, "I had a bad dream that you should not go to the capital," Caesar said, "No, Caesar shall go forth." Why did Caesar say Caesar shall go forth? Because he told his wife Campania, he said, "After all, my best friend Brutus would be there, so he wouldn't find me." And because of that, he went to the capital. He saw his friend Cassius, Casca, all of them, the senators. That time their mail had not been stolen. Amen. Well, I feel. And so they started stabbing him. This white guy did not steal the maize, but they attacked the king. Did you get that? They did not steal the maize, but they attacked the king. So something happens. And then they stabbed him. Caesar was ready to fight with the fish. So he saw Brutus coming. He thought that Brutus was coming to fight for him. And all that he heard was Pian. And he said, "And to Brute. And you too, Brutus." So an actually would say, "I've come to bury Caesar and not to mourn him, for the evil that Pedro lived after them." And he went for that to say in his oration that it was not the daggers of Carcass and Carcass that killed Brutus, the accused Caesar, but it was the stab of Brutus. That when Brutus stabbed, the blood that came out from Caesar's body was like a piece of diamond and a train of rain. And that is what led to the death of Caesar. Amen. The only way the good shepherd could be betrayed was the kiss. The kiss of Jesus. Amen. As of today, in the life of Israel, as the history continues, things became so bad that God decided that he will come down by himself. So, he sent his only begotten Son, our Lord and our Master Jesus Christ, to come and reveal to the world the true image of God. But Jesus did not come from the blue. He was already prophesied by the prophet Isaiah, Jeremiah. And of course, the way he will be treated was already analyzed by the prophets. And that is why when Jesus took the scroll of the prophet Isaiah chapter 61, he said, "The Spirit of the Lord has been given to me, for he has anointed me to give the good tidings to the poor.
to proclaim liberty
to the captives,
to set the downtrodden free, to open the eyes of the blind,
and to open the ears of the deaf.
Jeremiah 50:7.
All who came upon them have devoured them.
As their adversaries we have said, we are not guilty, inasmuch as they have sinned against the Lord, who is the habitation of the righteousness, even the Lord, the hope of their fathers.
Ezekiel 34:31.
As for you, my sheep, the sheep of my pasture, you are led and I am your God,
declares the Lord God.
Then 1 Peter 5:2-5.
Shepherd the flock of God among you, exercising oversight not under compulsion, but voluntarily, according to the will of God,
and not for solid gain,
not for solid money,
but with eagerness.
Nor yet as lording over those allotted to your charge,
but be a shepherd over the flock that has been entrusted to you.
Why are we trying to say this?
Because we are really the good shepherd
who told us today in the Gospel of St. John chapter 10,
I am the good shepherd.
The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep.
I don't want to start telling you how the shepherd operated in Israel,
because that has been already been given to us today in the gospel.
And so we go ahead then.
The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep.
He who is a hireling and not a shepherd,
he wouldn't do that.
He flees because he's a hireling,
will not protect the sheep.
He has knowledge about the sheep.
And Jesus said, I am the good shepherd.
For Jesus, a good shepherd is the one who can leave the 99 and the pig
and go in search of the one missing sheep.
And at the end of the day, when the good shepherd was going to prepare all the banquets,
in the context of the Passover of the Jews,
he did not enter the kitchen to cook a big curry for us.
He did not go and enter the kitchen to give us also a remain.
He did not go to the kitchen to give us a pot of meal.
He gave us his own flesh to eat.
And for wine,
the chapel that he blew
was his own blood.
This same good shepherd Jesus Christ who celebrated on Good Friday and Palm Sunday
and Good Friday
washed the feet of the disciples.
That you call me Master and Lord, and so I am.
If I can do the work of the meanest slave
to wash your feet, then you then should go out and do the same.
You want to be a master, then you have to be like a child.
What do you mean to be like a child?
Because a child is innocent.
You want to be older, then you have to empty yourself.
Why do you need to empty yourself?
Because a cup that is filled is already filled.
You cannot add anything to eat again.
Lord, I am weak and very human.
You know, because you have accepted your weakness,
because you accept how empty you are, even as a leader, God fills you with his grace.
And so Peter today can use the name of Jesus.
Very many prophets, kings, men and women because no one wants to die. There is a song in my language, Ibaco. The song of the toad. Oh, my, oh, my, if I go ask you, who wants to go to heaven? Everybody wants to go to heaven. Isn't it not so? But not many people want to die. So Jesus is the only one who came into the world to die for you and me. Let me tell you the problem Islam is having today in the world. In the Bible, it's very clear in the Old Testament. The verses that talk about war, the abandon of benefits. But Jesus came. Jesus is the founder of Christianity. He's not the founder of Judaism. So in Christian religion, you cannot kill somebody and say Allah Akbar. You cannot kill somebody and say in Jesus' name. But in the Quran, the verses, the Meccan verses, talk about peace to the extent that chapter 5 of the Quran says, if you kill one person, it is as if you have killed the whole world. And if you save one person, it is as if you have saved the whole world. These verses, the terrorists today don't use that. They concentrate on the verses of Medina, where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had become a great leader, was a political leader and a religious leader in Medina. So the verses talk about self-defense because he was defending himself. So the terrorists use this to form their ideology to kill and maim, to rape, to loot, booty. But Jesus is one man who never killed somebody. Even in agony, even when they were killing him, even when Peter wanted to defend him by cutting off the ear of Marcus, in agony Jesus performed the miracle and put back the ear. Those who carry the sword will die by the sword. So no Christian today can go and kill in the name of Jesus. And no prophet should go and exploit or pastor or priest exploit your followers, because Jesus Christ said the birds of the heaven and rest. The land is not ours, but the Son of Man has no way to place his head. And when he was commissioning the apostles, he said, carry no haversack, no pale tunic, no sandals, none. Why? Because Jesus knows very well that the people that are going to walk with will provide you these things. Remember how Abraham entertained the angels that were going to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. So Jesus, for me, and for you I'm sure, is better. And based on the perfection of Jesus, Peter was able to authoritatively and confidently tell us this morning in Acts of the Apostles chapter 4 verse 8 to 12, Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, rulers of the people of his elders, the rulers of the people of Israel, rulers of the people of elders, if we are being examined today concerning a good deed done to a cripple, by what means this man has been healed, be it known to you all and to all the people of Israel that it is by the name of Jesus who was crucified, who died for us, them that it is the name of this same Jesus that I was able to perform all these miracles.
And that is what life should be to them. The last Catan meeting, we were encouraged to start catechesis from Catholic politicians so that they will know wherever they are, no matter the position they occupy, that they are here as ambassadors of Christ. They should be willing to represent Christ the King. The things that are going on in Nigeria today cause or adjure us to cry out again to the Good Shepherds. On Good Friday, I had an interview on AIT, Kadaki. They asked me to come and talk about Good Friday and nation building. But their questions were more or less more of the political angle. And they asked me this question. The economy. How do you assess the economy of Nigeria? And this is what I told them. I'm not an economist. Good though I made A1 in economics in my secondary school. I'm not a financial analyst. But even the blind, even the deaf, knows that Nigeria has no economy. Because we are suffering. They say we are out of recession. Has the price of rice come down? Has the price of garri come down? They said we have defeated terrorists. Lea is still missing. Sick in the hands of the terrorists. And they asked me again, the pastors who are preaching God's prosperity, do you know one of the reasons that is leading to these mushroom churches? It's failure of government. There was work for every graduate. If there was a structure that works, many of these pastors, you will not see them. They will be very busy in their office. I can say that many pastors start their churches because they are hungry. There is what they call Al-Majiru in the north, or everywhere in Nigeria. But we please you to know that Al-Majiru is not an Islamic institution. Yes, it is an institution that emerged out of poverty, hunger, and promiscuity. Al-Majiri is not an Islamic constitution. What happened is that these men, they give birth to so many children, they don't even know, they can't train them, they throw them to a man to go and learn karate. And this man cannot take care of them. And these children need to think for themselves. Some of these children at the age of consciousness have started taking care of themselves. Though they go out to bed, bring food for the malam and from where the malam will feed them. If it is an Islamic institution, why don't you have an imam in Saudi Arabia? So, it is lack of self-control hunger. The children are not well taken care of. And that is why today, Oga can come out to say the children, the youth are lazy.
Yes, you know this story more than me. You know this story more than me.
But have the youth been given capacity? Have they been given space?
The others who didn't go through the same thing as I did got jobs immediately, and within 1 week or 1 month, they have got their own car.
Let me tell you what happened. But the disability is not far away. At least my brother came from it.
The generation that are really lost, like when they are graduates, those of them who quit go school. The only challenge they used to come at those days is the challenge of choice.
Correct.
Yes. When my elder brother was rounding up his NYC, he got two jobs, NNPC and Agric Bank. At that time, Agric Bank was running, so he opted for Agric Bank. When he finished, three bedroom flat waited for him. A brand new chair, rubber, new chassis, Mazda 626 was waiting for him. And I thank God I also enjoyed it. That's why we need to play wonderful music. He healed up. You know?
All those pharmacies to enjoy this music.
Every time I enter this room, I see the rooms, graduates are leaving.
Oh my God.
How many young graduates today can include what matter? 1 year old graduate, my elder brother. Whenever I go there, I have my own room in his house in Ibadan. These are the same people today that are telling us that we are lazy. My nephew has been at home for 9 years, no work, and made decision. I saw a first class graduate in Benin who is still looking for a job. Today, if you don't have somebody, if you don't have a politician to look for work for you, then you are there. Yeah. So we are in trouble. So the shepherd we have today are praying on the people. They are not praying for the people. And of course, today, when you are driving, all our political elites, they have police and soldiers guiding them. The Reverend Father, who is still in the days of the kidnappers, if he had escort, maybe they will not kidnap him. But today, things have fallen apart. Chinua Achebe, if he was still alive, today I don't know what he would have written. Because at that time, the things that fell apart was not like this. So.
When did Chinua Achebe say things fall apart? Chinua Achebe would not know that things will soon fall apart to the point that 5 men will beat all the security apparatus in the House of Assembly and go in and quietly go with the maze. What did Chinua Achebe have seen that? It's not the way things will fall apart, human beings will fall apart. So if that would happen, where is our security? So, my own security would be Psalm 90 or 91, depending on the Bible we are reading. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High, abides in the shelter of the Almighty, say to the Lord, my refuge, my stronghold, my God, in whom I trust. Who has said this stuff, don't we? So, the second reading of today is going to be our conclusion.
St. John is writing, see what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know him. If our politicians, our leaders, of course, according to
some of our social activists. We don't have leaders in Nigeria. Do you know what we have? Of, no! A ruler can measure straight. What we have, political office holders who are not here for the common good, who are not there because they want to serve you, but because they want to save money for 100 generations yet unborn. But what we want to tell us today is that as a leader, you should have the qualities of a good shepherd. Because we are God's children now, it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. So in spite of all this praying on us, we know that all will not be lost. Do you know why? Jesus in John chapter 14 says, do not let your heart be troubled. I'm going to prepare you a place so that where I am, you too will be. But we are not praying that this world will continue to be hell for us. We don't pray for perpetual good Friday. We don't pray for something without ending. We pray that someday, after the stormy waters, that we will arrive at the calm of the ocean. We pray that one day, a day very soon, that we will not contribute to the fire that is burning us. But the only way we contribute to the fire that is burning us, because the same entities are the thoughts that these our words are using to win the election. The Boko Haram we have today is born out of political doctrine. When Muhammad Yusuf was a pirate to get the governor of Borno State to win the election, and after they have done the job, he neglected them. You still did not fight Christians, were fighting government, the state government, because of what he was used to do. But how did he end up? He was killed extrajudicially. And that is what gave rise to the Boko Haram of Shekau. So the evil that men do, now live with them. So it's my prayer then that these people who are kidnapping us, they will be like the right people. So what are they can prevent the lot of our family and go and carry the maze? They should go to the front the inner silos to go and kidnap the signature. The ministers, they should go and kidnap them. Because one kidnap of a minister is made to that are trillion now. And that means they will get it that same day. Well, I'm not praying that this should happen. In Nigeria, be better.
Amen.
So that everybody will live in peace and harmony. So that God will give us political leaders who will be good shepherds. Who will not continue to exploit us. Because we are tyrants. We are really, really tired. So many things. Those who have led us to this level, may God forgive them. I really have a change of mind. So that by 2019, you and me will decide who should lead us to the next level. And that is why you should not have your BBC by losing it. Go and register and vote for credible leaders. May God bless and protect you as you help us to choose good shepherd for Nigeria through Christ our Lord.